Hey everyone, Shea Bear here.
Shea Bear 1000.
Hope y'all had a good Valentine's Day. Monkey got me a card and a huge, real thick, two gigantic. Every time I turn the camera on, never fails, does it? Open the garage door to get a little fresh air in this garage, and freaking car goes by. I ain't seen one all morning. Anyway, two big Reese's Cup hearts, peanut butter cups. It's pretty good. Nice little card. Thought I'd do a little vlogging with you. It's Friday. Got this thing here she wanted me to check. She was kind of concerned about. Let me get my spectacles on here. That's her charger for her phone. See the crack right there? You know she is. She's really dramatic about it. It's hanging on by a thread, but it's still working. I got another one for her, but she likes this one, so I got like 800 million of these things. Who doesn't, right? But we're gonna put some hot glue on there because I did check it. It is working fine. But if you find yourself in that situation, put you some hot glue around there. That's what we're gonna do right now. Put you a little bit of hot glue around there. Don't take a lot. You know, preventive maintenance, you can do this ahead of time. Just put a little bit around here and it'll keep that from happening. It'll last a little longer. But these things, you know, I mean, they get beat up. There you go. Yeah, and I laid it right on the table. Stupid. Now these ones that like come with your phone, if you look right there, you'll see that little for USB, that little symbol there, or it might say LG, or it might say, you know, Samsung, whatever your phone is. There's a quick little tip for you. There's not one on the other side. Now, the cheap ones you go buy at the dollar store or whatever, some of them don't have that. But if you got the originals, the good ones, they will have that. And you're always, you know, trying to plug it in, going, you know, whoops. Which way's it go, you know? Well, good rule of thumb is when it's got a printing on it like that, that will always go towards you, you know, towards the top. And you don't have to, all you do is look for that symbol. Some of them will have a dot on one side, you feel that dot. Or like these right here, see these ridges? You feel them ridges? That'll go just like that. And you don't have to look, especially in the dark. You feel them ridges? You know, it goes like that. So there you go. Just a quick little hack for you. So tomorrow, I'm going to try to get out for a little bit. Not a major, but there's a house I want to go look at. Well, I've looked at it before. It's the place is for sale, but the place is, you know, looks like it's abandoned, but it is for sale. I mean, it's not really abandoned, but it's pretty trashed and stuff. We're going to go check that out if I can tomorrow. I really want to go hike up into that plane crash. There's a plane crash out by where I'm going to, and I was going to do that before here a while back, but it rained the next day and I couldn't get after that. I couldn't, you know, we got busy and everything with working and stuff and just never got back there. So that's on my list. I really don't know if I'm up for a hike right now or not. I really don't think, you know, because it's you know, through the woods and stuff. So there's a couple houses that we know of, abandoned, run down, whatever you want to call it, vacant. It's been sitting empty for years and years and years, and we want to go check out. But that's one of them, if I can, if I fill up to it tomorrow, that's what I'm going to do. Because he drive right into the house. And as we turned around there when we went out for that plane crash, I went looking for it one day. And when I got home, what I did was I pinpointed my GPS on my phone and kind of like pinged myself. And when I got home, I checked the coordinates. I was like pretty much on it, so I was probably about within 50 to 75 yards away, if that. But it was, you know, it was grown up, so it's kind of hard to see. It's a small plane, it's an experimental plane, and I'll tell you the story as we do that. But like I said, I don't know if I'll be able to do that tomorrow or not, but I'm definitely wanting to go check that house out because I don't have to hike to it or anything, so that might be a go. So we'll have to see from there. So that's kind of like on the agenda for tomorrow. So I've got everything running now except for the trike. I do have a running engine to put on it if I have to, but it's a small engine. It'd be all right for a kid. It's only two horse Briggs. It's a vintage, which would probably be about in the same year as the trike itself, so that'd be kind of cool to put on it, you know, for a smaller kid. It probably would never haul me around. What's on it, I think maybe a 3.5 horse Tecumseh. I don't know. But I'm pretty confident it'll run. It's got spark. The carburetor's shot, you can tell that. I mean, I don't think I can get by cleaning it, so it would need a carburetor. But as far as that goes, I think that engine will run. Let's see. I got to get some kind of starting system on it. They cobbled up an electric start with a GM alternator on it and a Delco Remy starter generator is what they had on it. I mean, they did a good job on making it work, and it worked good, but I'm not going that route. Just pull starts, all that thing needs, nothing fancy. So I'm gonna try that here for long. I'm gonna, you know, see if it'll fire, it'll run. So we'll see what's going on with that. If not, like I said, I got that engine over there that I'm gonna put on it. In fact, we should just get it out and start it up right now. All right, guys. I don't know if you guys remember this little engine or not. It's a little, it's a 2-horsepower Briggs & Stratton. I bought it here a while back at a indoor flea market. I gave $38 for it. They've got this hooked up to it. So, we're going to put it on full choke. See, if you watch that right there, you pull this out to choke it, but with this, when you push this all the way forward, see that choke coming out there, right there? Alright, that's a choke. I haven't had this thing running in a while, so let's try it. Well, Briggs & Stratton, that's the way they start, right? So, anyway, she runs. Let's see what we got going on here. Might not have enough gas in it. Because I had it running for a while. Yeah, it looks a little dry. One day, just to let it run, and looks like there may be a little water in it. But, probably condensation from some sitting out here in the garage. Just try a little brake parts cleaner here. Carburetor parts cleaner, whatever. But that's the way this thing will start every time. hitting the... See, if you pull it clear back, all the way back, it kills... If there's a kill switch inside there, it kills it. So, that's what I'm doing. This thing's light, but man, not for me it ain't. So, that's that. That's like get stuff out and fired up. A couple weekends ago. Was it last weekend? I dragged the Christmas tree around back, cut it up with the chainsaw. A chainsaw, it was brand new. I bought it again at a flea market. It's brand new, it'd never been run. This stuff come from a state sale. The only thing I can imagine is when we had Hurricane Irma, this stuff come from an old, you know, an older gentleman, older guy, and who had passed away. And everything they had there from his place was nice. And it's just a Poland chainsaw. It'd never been run. Never been started. Apparently, he bought it just in case. So he passed away a short time after that. So never been run. I started up. I never used it. I tried it out on a stump out here just to see if it was cutting good. It run good and everything. So I took it and I cut up that Christmas tree. And that was the first time I actually used it. First time it's ever actually been used. But I don't think... when I checked it, it didn't even smell like gas in the gas tank. The oil tank for the chain was dry as a bone. I mean, it hadn't been cleaned out. You can tell it was brand new. I think I gave $30 for it, $35. I don't know, something like that, because I got like, I bought it on Saturday. Sunday they have like a half off sale on certain items, and certain items like that was like 25% off or something. So they gave me the 25% off discount on Saturday. That, since I told them, well, you know, I live kind of ways away, I probably won't make it back tomorrow. And they said, well, you know, I wanted to make a sale because it was like middle of summer or just going into summer. It was really hot. It was like, you know, it's not going to sell right now anyway, so he let me have it for that. It ended up being, you know, like 30 or, like $35 with tax or something, so I got steel on it. I got two more over there. I got a Black Hawk. It's a Poland. I got another Poland. I forget what it is. They're all three about the same. Black Hawk doesn't run. The other one, I don't know. It needs, it's got good compression, but it needs, I noticed someone had taken the coil off of it, so I may take the coil off the Blackhawk and put on it and see if it runs. If it runs, then I'll buy a coil for it and put on it, and I'll sell two and keep one for myself, you know, just to have around here. And we always got, you know, we're surrounded by trees, we always got tree limbs coming down and stuff. You never know when you need to trim something, whatever, but it's not eating anything. I mean, I got the Black Hawk, I gave $15 for. The other one I gave $5 or $10 for. Maybe I'll say $10 to be safe. There's 25 in two of them, and I know the Black Hawk runs. I've had it running. Let's see. So, the, you know, that was worth the... Yeah, that was $20, so... So that's, what, $30 into, or 15... No, no, it was 15 for the Blackhawk, 10 for the other one, and it was, so I got 25 in them. I got 35 in the other one, actually 30, you know, I really don't count tax, but, so, anyway, I got, what, $55 and 3 chainsaws, and if I can't get that out of one of them to get my money back and still keep one, you know, then I'm doing something wrong, right? Let me see. Again, the scooter's running fine. I gotta get a battery for it. They're cheap. I'll get one offline. Backpack blower's running perfect. I got it up for sale. The weed eater. The Bolin's. Yeah, the Bolin's weed eater. Runs like a brand new one. I got two different heads for it. I think I'm gonna put it up for sale. And probably one of the chainsaws too, but I got a backpack blower for sale. I'm gonna put the weed eater up for sale. Probably one of the chainsaws. Scooter's gonna go for sale as soon as I get a battery in it. Everything's working on it now. The high beam, remember I told you the high beam was out. It was out, but it wasn't a bulb. It was just a loose wire from when I had taken it off. Plugged it back in. I did. What it was I didn't clip the plug all the way until it snapped. So, on it, horn works. You guys probably saw that video. The only thing I got to do is I got to get the banjo bolt for the brake line for the front brakes, their hydraulic brakes. That one I believe had a drum brake on the front. Looks like it's been it's been upgraded because they upgraded a lot of stuff on it. The mirrors are not original. They're upgraded mirrors. It just had the black mirrors on it, you know, black plastic mirrors, whatever. It's got the chrome ones on it now, more like motorcycle mirrors. Like I said, I think, and what's cool about that is the front wheel and back wheel are interchangeable on it. It's just the assembly inside that's different, like in the drum. I think it had a drum brake on the front of it because everything I'm pulling up on the internet for that bike, all the pictures and everything I've seen, like advertisements for that bike, had drum brakes on it. This one has got the hydraulic system on it. It's got a disc brake on it, so that's so it's been upgraded. So it's running pretty good. I got to start the boat motor up. It needs gas. I ran it out of gas last time I had it running, so that way it wouldn't have gas sitting in it for a long time. So we'll do a old start on it here soon. Alright guys, I couldn't resist. I dumped a little bit of fuel out of my backpack blower. Put in here and let's give it a shot. I'm gonna prime it up. I started with a choke off. These are backwards on these cheap things, these cheap motors. See, this side's all faded, some faded, but this engine's not even broke in yet. Where it says on, the choke is actually off. I keep forgetting that. These are printed backwards. So if you get one of these, you want the choke off, it's actually on. So it actually started with the choke off. That runs. I got a boat motor for sale. I got a 35 horsepower Mercury for sale. It's in the backyard. It runs. The big boat, 15-foot boat out there, the air glass is for sale. It runs. It starts up and runs. The car does start up and run. It's just not real dependable. I wouldn't trust the engine in it. The engine, it's fine. It's just the top end. It's got a lot of valve noise in it, so. And I think it's got the timing chains clattering a little bit in it, so. But that's a little bit later. We're going to get an engine for it, drop the engine down in it. That'll be a couple episode video there. I'll do a video on taking it out, a video dropping it down in, and then probably a video of starting it up and test driving it. So, of course, you guys saw the cameras. They all work. I'm not on an old camera today, but as I just threw this one up on the stand, it was all ready to go. So, looks like I got about half battery life. I'm going to need to charge it soon. So that's about it for now. So there's my vlog, just kind of chit-chat with you guys. I got a couple things I want to do in here and get them done today. The closet door is working fine. So the bifold door, accordion style door, whatever you prefer, it seems like. It's working fine. She's happy with it, so. Because one time, like I said, it was like, kept wanting to fall off, and I told her, I said, well, that bottom piece has been in it, and I said, it's kind of worn here. That was the last time it was kind of fiddled with, and then it just, you know, we just took it down off there before it fell down, and I told her then, she remembered, she says, I remember you saying that you was going to have to put a plug in there or something, and she said, now I know what you meant. She said, now I know why you wanted to save them old paintbrushes. I said, yeah, for stuff like that. So she's happy with it. Of course, she's at work. I think she's off tomorrow, but anyway, I got to get out of the house for a little bit tomorrow, and I'm going to spend a little time with her. We didn't really do anything yesterday for Valentine's Day, you know what I mean? I went with her to her work. She goes and does patients. She does a personal care, and so I just sit and wait in the truck, so I kind of rode around with her for a little bit yesterday. Had to get, like I said, you gotta get out of the house once in a while. No matter how sick you are, you gotta get out, man. So, let's see. That's about it, guys. I just want to say thanks again, everybody, for joining me and starting up the old engine here. I still don't know what year it is. I'm thinking early 70s. I'm thinking it might be late 60s. I haven't really delved into it. I can tell if, you know, if I pull the cover off of it, the pull rope thing, you know, the recoil. If I pull the starter rope off of it, look down in a flywheel, that might give me an idea. But I've done some checking, and from what I'm seeing, it's late 60s, early 70s on pictures I'm bringing up on Google that people have for sale that are like identical to it, except for the air cleaner. I don't think that air cleaner is original. I just don't think that's the original air cleaner for it. I think it had one of them flat ones that was kind of cut out around the muffler. I think the muffler, yeah, I believe the muffler is original on it, but I don't think the air cleaner is. I know this nut is not, you know. That's just something, you know. But, you know, it does have a good air cleaner in it. I think you guys seen it. But I do believe it was supposed to take one of them ones that kind of went around like this. I could be wrong, though. I don't know. I'll have to do some more research, and I'll get back with you guys as soon as I find out something on it. It could be original, but I know that nut's not original, though. So, but anyway, guys, so that's that. So everything I got runs except for the trike. So we'll have it running this spring, and we'll get it going, and I'll put it up for sale or trade it for something, make another video on. So anyway, again, got, where are you going? Again, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys have a great weekend. Thanks for supporting my channel. Appreciate it. And this vlog is over. Shea Bear, Myth the Man, Legend. I'm gone for now. Bye-bye, guys. Thanks again.